una visione totale, no?
Why this film? Why I'm a cop?
No, what the scene in this film? But Fellini is our, for me, is the number one, not just in the Italian cinema, but in the cinema. It's cinema. For me, Fellini is cinema. Cinema is Fellini.
What do you like particularly in this scene?
What is this scene? The scene is incredible, no? It's very beautiful. Don't you think that it's so poetic, no? It's really amazing, you know, incredible. I like this. I like Ishashi. When you say the stones, you know, you say are beautiful the stones. You know, this is something that for me is incredibly deep. You know, I like this presence of the madman. You know, the mental illness is something mysterious. You know, and the guy is called Theo. That means God, you know, and so it's beautiful from, you know, the fact that God is mysterious, you know, like the madman, you know, he's a madman.
Can I interrupt you for a second?
Sure.
An English writer used to say that a madman is a man who has lost everything but his reason, which is exactly what he said. Go on, sorry.
Yes, then it's something reminding me of my childhood, because I saw this movie when I was a child, and this is a classic movie, so every time you see it, it's saying something new. And I have a zia, I used to say, an aunt, the sister of my brother, the sister of my father, that was that have a mental
illness.
It was a mental delay, I say, no? Mental, yes. And so, this scene reminds me of something that I lived personally, you know? The presence of, in a family, of somebody that is totally unpredictable,
unpredictable. You don't know what to do.
You know, you don't know what to do, you know? But for me, the relation with this aunt, when I was little, was very, you know, because children are bad. No? And so for me, she was like a child, you know? And so we and my brother, we were very bad with that. You know, making tricks, making jokes, you know? And
be cruel.
Cruel also, no? And she was cruel too, you know? And it was like a competition between us and her. But it was a beautiful relationship. It was a very pure relationship, you know? And sometimes we went to take her, because when she became more old, she was took in an institute of nuns. Yeah. And so sometimes we went there to take her, and we took her to our house and have lunch together and have dinner together. Maybe she slept in the house. So this scene is so familiar to me. It's so familiar. And The time, the use of the time, the pace, yes, that Fellini does with the scene is really musical, you know. This is music, it is not just images, this is music, you know, the rhythm of the scene. It's so real, you know, that you really feel like you're in it, you know, it's life, pure life, you know. And, you know, it's a beautiful scene, you know, the scream, Voglio una donna, you seen it with the subtitles, you know. And so, this is something that maybe make you feel, make you lose something. Because when I saw it the first time, this what Fellini does is that the first time he screams, you don't understand what he says, you know. So it's a primal scream, you know. And he says, oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. You don't understand what he says. And this is important in the meaning of in the scene, because it's a primal scream, and the primal scream is always Voglio una donna, you know, it's always, you know, it's that, you know, it's the primal need, you know, a woman, you know, there is a mother, there is a lover, there is somebody that with to go on in life, you know. And so the madman that screams Voglio una donna, it's a so desperate scream, you know. So it's really desperate. And so I think, you know, this scene can be compared with with the Sistine Chapel and with the Divina Commedia and with the Hamlet. You know, this is something that in 1,000 years somebody will see it and will have the same emotions that we had today, because that's art, you know. And Fellini was the greatest artist of the 19th century for me in Italy.
Can I just add briefly that, especially for my Italian cinema students, that one of the genial ideas of Fellini was to cast in the role of Theo Ciccio Ingrassia, yeah, who was a very popular Italian comedian, but at the time almost forgotten and considered as, you know,
considered cheap, no?
Yeah, like, absolutely. Yes. Second or third
rate. B movie guy.
And I also love not only the stones, the sashi, come dicono loro, but also the idea of the egg, the perfection of the egg, the mystery of the nature. They reminded me another film by Fellini that I adore, La Strada. There is a moment where Il Matto, the fool, watching some little stones, says, if these little stones mean nothing, even the stars mean nothing.
Yeah.
And this is pure Fellini. He's always impressed by the mystery, the beauty, the purity of nature. I don't want to say too much. I think it's time for Stefano to call.
I think we are approaching the end of our evening. And before we thank Lorenzo, we're going to see Fango. That is actually, you talked about going to Brazil.
I was also half joking. We've been to Brazil because we were looking for a forest, you know, for the feeling of the primal forest, of the rainforest. And so we shoot this video in a legendary location, because we shoot it in the Iguazu Falls. That is the same place where they shoot The Mission, you know, the Roland Joff movie. And, you know, everybody, a lot of that, of you maybe have seen that movie, you know, and the location of the movie is much important as the movie.
How do you like The Mission?
I like it.
Which version do you want to see, Lorenzo? There are two versions.
I don't know, there are two versions, because this video, we had some problem at the end with the editing of this video, you know. We had an idea in our mind and we shoot, and then when we tried to edit the video, we didn't, we were unable to find a good rhythm inside the editing of the images between my playback and the rest of the shooting, and that was a problem, you know. We were in the editing studio and we say, it doesn't work like that, it's fake, and it's, you know, it doesn't work. But we had, you know, made the video, so we couldn't throw away the material, because we spent a lot of money and that. So we decided to do two versions of the video, one with the playback, just with the playback, and one with the other scenes, you know, because together they didn't work. Separately they work. I don't know, let's see. Maybe the playback. The playback. So
which one is it?
Lo chiedo a my wife. What is it? Because she's more objective in that. The playback.
Let's give a hand to Francesca.